Okay, so now it is time to create the second of our three classes, the game state class. The purpose of this class is to save and load game data to and from a file on the hard drive. In short, this class, the class that we're going to be creating now, is going to perform the main work of loading and saving data to the hard drive. Now this class is going to be called the game state class. I'm going to create it as I created the class previously by right clicking on the classes folder here in the Solution Explorer and choosing add new item from the context menu. I'm going to select Unreal Script file and I'm going to call this class game state. And I'm going to click the Add button at the bottom right-hand side of the dialog. Notice that this class here is called GameState and it extends from the Object class. And that is exactly the class that I want to extend from on this occasion. It perhaps is not very often that we need to do that, but here it is appropriate. Now, I want to say a few things before proceeding with this class. I want to say a few things about how data is saved in the UDK, and I want to spend some time justifying why I have chosen to do this the way that I have. There are at least two main methods for saving data to a file in Unreal Script. One method is perhaps the config file method or the ini file method. Using this method, I can select a number of different properties in my class that I can save to a text-based ini file. So that's one method that I could have used, but it is not the method that I have chosen here. I have chosen another method, which we might call the save object method. Now, it's not really key at the moment that you know what that is. We're going to be seeing what the save object method is and what it involves. But I want to just list two reasons why I have chosen to use this save object method. The first reason is that the save object method allows us to choose to specify the file and the path at which the information is saved. So I can choose to save my information to a file anywhere or almost anywhere on the hard drive. I can save on multiple occasions and on each occasion I can save to different files. So in short, the save object method allows the user, if they wish, to choose exactly where on the hard drive their data is saved. The second reason I chose the save object method is because the config ini file method, well, that saves data in a text-based file, a file that a user could open up and edit or change to suit their needs, really. The save object method, however, saves information to a binary file. That is, it saves it to a proprietary format, a format that's not really clear to the user how it is arranged, and it makes it harder for the user to change the contents of the file, and so it makes it harder for them to cheat. Of course, it's not impossible that the user could change the file, but still, it's trickier than it would be if we had chosen the ini file method. So let's take a look at this game state object and see how it works with this basic save object method. Now, the save object method, what it basically allows us to do is to save a complete class, to serialize a complete class or an instance of a class in memory. It allows us to save that to a file on the hard drive. And then we can, at a later time, load that file back and replicate the class in memory, recreate the class on the basis of the file. So what that means is that our GameState object, this class, the best way to implement this is to have this GameState class as a record that records all of the properties or the current state of the level at any one time. If this GameState class contains all of the sensitive and important properties of the level at any one time, we know that by saving this class to a file on the hard drive, we effectively save the complete state of the level. We can load back the state of the level at any time by loading from the file that we saved. So the save object method is a way to save and load an object to a file on the hard drive. So let's get started then at coding this game state object. If the game state class is to be effective in saving data to a file on the hard drive, then it must know about all of the relevant information in the level, about all of the information that must be saved. We can say straight away that there is some information that doesn't need to be saved. For example, we won't need to save whether the level has walls and a floor and a ceiling. We don't need to save all the material information that's applied to those surfaces. All of this information is saved already in the level file that we created using the UDK editor. We constructed and we built the level and we saved it to a level file. We didn't cover that in this tutorial, but we can safely say that at some point this level, the level that we're working with, was built and was saved to a standard UDK level file. That information we won't need to store in the save game file. But when the user runs this level, when the user plays our level, they are able to spawn cubes into the level using the spawn cube console command. We don't know in advance how many cubes the user will spawn. We don't know the location that the user will set these cubes. These pieces of information are unknown, and these pieces of information are critical, meaning that we must save them to disk. These sorts of things are the things that the game state class needs to know about in order to save our level correctly. It needs to know all of the cubes that are in the level. It needs to know their locations. It must save this data so that we can load the level back and for the cubes to be set at the correct locations. Now, to save this information, I'm going to create an array of data structures. The data structure will contain information, will contain a reference to the cube actor and to its location. It will contain information about those two properties. And we're going to have an array of these data structures. The array, or the length of the array, will equal the number of cubes in the level. If there are 10 cubes in the level, our array will have 10 elements. If there are 5 cubes in the level, our array will have 5 elements. So let us now start to create this data structure. I'm going to create struct here, game object struct, like so. And our structure is going to have, as I said, two properties, var actor reference. This is a reference to the cube actor, and var vector location, which represents the 3D location of the cube in the level. We are going to have an array of these game object structures, since the level could have more than one cube. And since we don't know in advance how many cubes there are going to be spawned, we're going to use a dynamic array. That is an array that can grow and shrink at runtime, an array that will allow us to add and remove elements as and when we need them. The size of a dynamic array is never fixed. So I'm going to create var array of game object structs like this. I'm going to call the array game objects. And now we have created a structure, which is here, and we have also created an array of those structures. Of course, This array is not populated with anything right now, but we're going to add some functionality to do that. Now, in essence, saving the game state object is really about saving this game object structure to a file on the hard drive. And loading the level is really a case of loading the game object array back from a file on the hard drive. But right now, we have no functionality to add anything to this array. We have a structure and an array of those structures, but nothing is ever added to this array. We're going to create a function now to do this. This function, I'm going to code beneath the array. I'm going to call it function cube add. And it's going to take as a parameter cube memory cube. You might recall that cube memory is the name of our cube class that we created in the previous section. And this function cube add is going to take a reference to a cube object, and it will add that to the game objects array. The cube add function is not going to be called internally by this class. It is going to be called by the game info class that we will add in the next section. Now, the cube add function, I'm going to add at the top of here a local variable, which is going to be game object struct. I'm going to just call this GS for game structure. And the first thing we're going to do is assign a location to the structure, which is going to be the location of the cube actor. It's going to take the location of the cube actor that's passed in here, and it's going to assign it to the location property of the game object structure. And we're also going to take a reference to the cube actor itself. And then finally, we're going to add this structure to the game object array. We can do that using the add item method. Going to type game object dot add item, and I'm going to pass the object GS, and that completes the function. When this function is called, when this function cube add is called and is passed a cube in the level, it will create the necessary game object structure and will add that to the array. The next two functions that we're going to be working on for this class are the functions that actually save and load this array or all the properties of this class to a file on the hard drive.